I didn't want to get back to work, that's for sure. Jesus.
Good evening and Happy New Year. Welcome to Plymouth High School basketball. The boys tonight entertain West De Pere. And West De Pere comes in tonight at 3-4 and 2-1 in conference. They just lost to Hortonville 70-50. While our Panthers come in at 4-3, 1-1 in conference. They just lost to Ashwaubenon 78-64. Garrett Kaiser, Josh Oppenheimer, and Mark Melcher bringing the action tonight. Josh, tough ball game before this.
Yeah.
Panthers came out, but looks like we'll have another good ball game tonight.
Yeah, don't let the West De Pere record of 3-4 fool you. These guys can play. They're physical. They're big. They had a great football season. So usually when you have a good football season, the start of your basketball season, you know, starts slow, and then as the season goes on, it picks up. So even though they're 3-4 right now, they're a very talented team. But so is Plymouth. Plymouth is, you know, 4-3. They got guys that can play. They got, you know, both teams are athletic. They got guys. Both teams can jump out of the gym. They just know how to play. They're going to play good, hard defense tonight. You know, this is, you know, when these are talk about going to high school basketball games, these are the games you really want to go and watch because it's going to be a fun game to watch tonight.
For De Pere, you've got Thomas Walder, now our senior number 10, is starting at one guard. Ethan Heck, another senior number 12, and another guard number 23, Easton Deshaun. At one wing, another wing is Langdon Norgard, number 33, and number 34, Sutter Deshaun. I think there's more Deshauns on this whole school,
right.
I think.
Right. Yeah, you're going to see a lot of names like Ethan Hack, Andrew Baumgart. Those are their two big scorers on the team. You'll hear their name called quite a bit tonight.
Panthers with their normal starting. Caden Schultz, Dylan Sass, Andrew Miller, Jordan Schmidt, and Jake Jakewood. Panthers quickly moving the ball after the tip.
Phantoms in their man-to-man defense. Plymouth running their motion, just their motion offense.
Jakewood gets the first jumper, bounces around and in.
Nice shot by Jakewood coming off the baseline. Good pull up for him. You know, between Jake Watt and Caden Schultz, they both average 13, 14 points a game, respectively. So it should be a fun night for both teams.
I know Plymouth didn't have school yesterday, which one of the few that didn't.
Yeah, the first day back today after a long winter break. You got a day, snow day before. So
that pass goes out of bounds.
Good job by Jordan Schmidt playing defense there, forcing them to throw the pass a little wider than they wanted to, which results in the out of bounds.
Quickly down court. Sosh misses a shot. Miller kicks it back out. Schultz with a long three. And we'll take that. 5-0 quickly for the Panthers.
Kate leads them in three-point percentage, about 42% on the air shooting.
Off the back rim. Jaco tips it around, tipped around. He's back to West De Pere, taking the Ashwaubenon. The last game, Jaco to the rebound for the Panthers. Schultz coming down court. Tries to slip. Gets it back.
Good cut by Jaquat. Gets it down low.
And intercepted. Quickly down court. And Heck gets their first basket. No cover on that basket for them finally.
No, right? Yeah. You know, Ethan leads them in scoring, but he also leads them in shot attempts too. So he's going to get a lot of breakouts, get a lot of points for him.
Jake was tipped around. And Heck with his second bucket. 4-5, Plymouth up by one.
Panthers working it around. Trying to get, yep, Kate Schultz back out for three.
And it gets off the back. Yep. The support of the backboard. Turnover. Balder coming down with the ball slowly across half court. Quickly they go into their offense. Long three goes off backboard. No rim. Schmidt with the rebound. Quickly down to Sass.
You've seen early on, both teams are going to look to get guys out on the break. Getting the wings, trying to get an easy basket.
Kick it back out. And I think Coach Grahn was open.
Right.
About the only one over there. Tom Blod coming into the Panther lineup.
It's like coming out in a little bit of a trapping defense here, slow up the Panthers.
And Baumgard comes in for West De Pere. Goes off the rim, but there's Jaquat with a nice tip.
Good job.
Nobody
by
blocked
Jack.
Him out. 7-4, Panthers up.
Schultz moving his feet well, good there on defense. Making Thomas Waldner working a little bit, bringing the ball up.
Tipped around, Schmidt gets a steal. He'll bring it down.
Andrew Miller.
Andrew Miller gets a three-pointer.
Nice basket by Andrew. Got his feet set.
A quick drive. Walder. And I think the police officers down in the corner were the ones open this time.
Right.
We've got to look for the guys in the white uniforms and the orange uniforms.
Tom Blod and Mark Petrolka in for Sasa and Miller.
You back out.
Three there.
Quick three.
Easton Duchesne. That's
Easton Duchesne. Quick steal. Good spin move. Quick get out.
Oh, 35. Andrew Baumgard takes a deep three. Holy cow. My guess, that kid's a middle linebacker on their
basketball team too.
Wow.
He's a pretty big kid.
He's a beast.
And tipped around again, and as we stay in at Plymouth.
I'm talking to Coach Schultz yesterday about him. He's like, I don't remember seeing a kid that big, that physically strong at a varsity game. I mean, he is just a brute out there. 12:57 to go in a half. Panthers down 2, 10-12. Alex Ames in the game for the first time. Take Schultz a little breather. Turnover by the Panthers. Phantoms ball.
A couple of errant passes on both teams. I don't know when that game with Ashwaubenon was for the West De Pere, but we haven't played in quite a while.
They played last Friday, the 30th. It's a travel. There you go. Good call by the referees there. Trying too hard, trying to force that action a little bit. Got his feet tangled up.
Looks like they'll put a little half-court pressure on.
Panthers
out to Jake Wood, quick it over to Ames again.
Patiently got it across, got into their offense, running a little bit of a matchup zone. I don't know if that's their MO or is this something new by West De Pere, but.
Nothing to throw them off just a little bit.
Well, you got Ethan Hack out there. He's got a pretty long wingspan. You're gonna have to really get it over him. Panthers get it down to the short corner, kick out to Jordan Schmidt for three. He's good.
And just that quickly. That was good ball movement, good recognition by the Panthers.
Great offensive set by them.
Tipped around, it stays with De Pere. And again, another dance step.
The travel.
Jake Shutter coming into the ball game for Jaquet. We'll get a little shorter out on the floor.
Yeah, you know, the nice thing about Shutter is he's a pretty tough kid. He's going to mix it up with Duchesne down there. He's not going to be afraid to mix it up with him. West De Pere out of their
went
matchup
back to
zone,
man.
Back
yep.
to man.
And Trika throws up. Shot that goes a little wild.
11:15 and a half. Panthers up one, 13-12.
Norgard back into the ballgame. Heck comes out for De Pere.
So is Easton Duchesne back in. I think we could just start the Duchesne family out there tonight. Kraft for a three from the corner.
A lot of threes going up and going in, unfortunately, for the Panthers.
Well, it's kind of like that way in the JV game tonight. We shot a lot of threes from both teams. They all went in. I feel like this is going to be the same way.
That gave a little blocking foul.
Panthers running their baseline out of bounds. Blights get it out to Vlad. Phantoms in their matchup zone.
Well, it looks like Shutter had a shot.
There you go. Well, they're not forcing it, which is a good thing. Good take by Troca. Get a foul.
Baumgarten picks up that foul. That's their second foul.
Troca to the line for two. It's the first one. We've got Andrew Miller and Jack Jaquet in. Blod and Shutter are out. Good crowd here tonight for the Panthers.
Troika gets one out of two. Tie ball game at 15. That is almost a jump ball.
Yeah.
Let it go.
Norgaard from corner. It's a three.
Schultz a little strong off the back of the rim. And Sass knocks it away. Heck, back into the ball game for De Pere. De Pere under their own basket. Kick it way back.
Deep inbounds, there you go.
To the backcourt. Heck brings it across. Morowitz back in the ball game for De Pere as well.
Good post defense by Saz. He's giving up about 6 inches there. He's doing it, working his tail off. Phantoms being patient, not trying to force everything.
They ran into their own man. Now we're going to get a jump ball. It'll stay down this way. Schmidt coming back into the ball game for Troika.
Panthers playing very good defense. As I say that, they give up a three.
Whoops.
But they're earning it,
and
right?
Norgaard.
West De Pere is earning it. Every shot they make, it's not in the wide open look, right? They're working it. Nice dump down to Jack Jaquot by Miller.
Jaquot quickly gets. Jaquot with 6 points for the Panthers. Another three going up.
Borowitz up with.
It's a long rebound, and not going to go in, but we're going to get a foul. Be two shots.
Miller and Bold tackle a tough and compacted end of the driveway snow with a Simplicity single-stage snow thrower featuring the snow shredder. Serrated auger available at Miller & Bolt. Multiple serrated services provide advanced ice chopping and snow clearing power to help you change your driveway this winter. We could have used that the other day. Hopefully you guys all got your snowblower the other day.
It does well on my raindrops.
Paddock Club. Visit the Paddock Club located in downtown Elkhart Lake where Chef Lynn Chisholm celebrates the bounty of local farmers using old world techniques by making artisanal handmade pasta, bread, house smoked meats, sandwiches, and so much more. Visit the Paddock Club in 61 South Lake Street.
Question.
Downtown Elkhart Lake.
A little question going on. I'm not sure what.
Looks like the book might be off a little bit. They're making sure that everyone's.
Well, don't check with me.
Yeah.
My unofficial score sheet here. West De Pere has a question, I think. They're counting or checking on the score. Usually the home team is a official score, and they've got
it.
I guess they got it right.
Doesn't seem either coach is mad, so.
He's not leaving. He's just walking down the end.
Yeah, so I don't. We're all good here. Panthers are bringing the ball up. Running a little trap there. Slow down the Panthers.
Looks like they're staying at 2-1
Panthers
two
is
zone.
Around. Get down the short corner to Schmidt. There you go. Kicks it back out. Working it. Good kick.
Whoa. Oh. Needed a fielder's glove to get that one down by the ankles. Unfortunately, another bad pass. Drive hard to the basket. Walder.
Yeah, Thomas Walder. Hard take. Panthers get the rebound on the miss. Bring it up. Get Jack Jaquot in the corner. Andrew Miller diving down the lane. Gets the ball. Puts it up for two. Gets the Panthers back within three. 19-22 with 7:30 to go in the half.
We'll get Jaquot that assist on that play.
Panthers still playing really good defense. Making the Phantoms go, you know, maybe off just their rhythm just a little bit. That's a tough take by Walder.
Walder gets that drive and bucket. Quickly into Jaquot across it. Nice move.
There you go, Andrew Miller with
good little
nice
fake and low layup, reverse layup by Miller.
I think I saw his dad do that shot in the early 90s. Unfortunately, his dad missed that shot.
And turn around is fair play, I guess, with a reverse layup on the other end. Heck with that basket. Out of bounds to the Panthers on the side. Jaquot comes out for a break.
Panthers can go about 9-10 deep, and they're not missing much of a beat. Schmidt from short corner just rims out. Good look by Jordan Schmidt. Phantoms bringing it up. Holy cow. Surprised that guy's shirt doesn't rip in half when he brings his arm over his head. Man, he's a big boy.
Schmidt trying to work inside. Brings it back out.
Good take by Andrew Miller.
Nice very drive by take. Miller. Miller with nine.
26-23. 5:50 to go. Panthers down three. Phantoms another deep three. They do have a green light. They all can shoot. Which could cause a little trouble for Panthers. Top block from the corner. Good luck.
Then tipped around. Schmidt goes down.
Oh, Jesus. He brings his elbows up like that. That'd be very...
Lod gets the first foul.
Bring your elbows
first
up
foul.
Like that. Foul on the Panthers underneath. Ames and Trocha back into the game for
not many fouls so far.
Yeah,
two
it's
apiece.
Been a pretty clean game. Heck with the old alley-oop out of bounds play. Just throw it up there.
Heck with Panthers,
the bucket. Get it across half court. Schmidt from the corner for three.
Off the rim. Quickly out.
There you go.
Good
defense.
Good
steal by Alex Ames. Good hustle steal by Alex Ames, I should have said.
That's right.
Hustling back. Panthers working it around their motion offense.
Kick it back out.
Yeah.
And
travel.
Dance step. Speaking of that dance step.
Yeah. Usually when they swing that ball from one side to the other before they take off, they're going to –
the dance line is in front of us, and they'll be performing at halftime.
Yeah.
I'm hoping that none of those basketball players want to join the dance line. They're looking like it every once in a while with those steps. But Panthers down five with just 4.5 left in the first half. Trocha picks up that foul.
Yeah, right now, Phantoms pretty much balanced scoring. All five guys out on the court right now have scored. Heck with eight, and everyone else with two or three. Panthers still looking for some scoring from Ooh. Everyone.
Step back jumper.
Heck with that step back. Kraft. Riley Kraft with a nice offensive rebound put back. It's fouled.
Shutter picks up the foul. Nobody in any real foul trouble, but off the rim, tipped around. Jakewood gets the board.
Doesn't get the old-fashioned three-point play. Panthers get the rebound. Bring it up. Get that skip pass.
That skip pass needs to be a little bit more loft.
Yep.
That's a tough pass to make. Panthers inbounding in front of the crowd. Jaquette
with a nice move.
And he gets the bucket, yeah. And we get a...
I know that West De Pere thinks that's a charge, but when the kid's in the air and in he comes and sets himself, he's already in the air. That was a good call.
Jaquette on the line for one, and he adds to his total.
Gets him back within four.
Not going to have that shot, but they will get the foul beforehand. Ames picks up his foul. All of a sudden, we've talked about not many fouls, and guess what happens?
Yeah, we're... Someone's going to get a bonus pretty quickly. Heck with a nice fadeaway.
Well, there's a great shot.
We've got double figures.
He's at 11. Well, I got him for 10.
Panthers moving it around. And Phantoms in their matchup 2-3 zone. Marco pulling it out, forcing the Panthers just to regroup a little bit.
Here's where you need to pass the ball. Send somebody in the gaps and pass it.
Here you go. We got it down the short corner. That's what you want to do.
Sometimes a little screen on top and the overload, that might help.
Yeah.
And a Jaquette. Jaquette with a jumper gets blocked, tipped around, tipped out, and it stays Panthers' way.
There's a whole hockey substitution for the Panthers. 2:45 to go. Panthers on six.
Schultz with a three. Off the front of the rim. Tipped around by Schultz. I mean by Schmidt. Yeah, guy saved by West De Pere. They're going to get up. They'll get Schultz.
It was a tough sequence for Caden there. Missed a three and goes down and takes a foul.
Yeah, they're going to put Walder on the line for two.
Plymouth Furniture is located on Eastern Avenue in Plymouth. They have over 40 mattress styles on display from Tempur-Pedic, Sealy, and Stearns & Foster. Plymouth Furniture has the largest selection of furniture and mattresses in the area with amazing sofa selection. Sofas, recliners, lift chairs, lodge furniture, dining room furniture, custom-made Amish furniture, and bedroom furniture. They carry quality brands like Flex Steel, Southern Motion, Best, and Ashley. Make sure you stop at Plymouth Furniture, 2133 Eastern Avenue. 2020 Visions, just a reminder, 2020 Visions, they do accept insurance from employees of Kohler, Sargento, Masters Gallery, Johnsonville, and many more. You can find them on Facebook at 2020 Visions or check out their website at www.20-20visions.com.
Walter hits both of those.
Got a good first half going here.
2 minutes, just over 2 minutes left. Panthers could use a bucket.
Panthers not just forcing stuff. Good shot by Sauce for three.
And he gets on the board.
Good look.
Cuts that lead to five.
Yeah. Deep three by Phantoms.
Hans around.
Big gets the rebound. Gets out to Schultz.
He gets blocked.
That's out of travel. He let go of the ball.
And it was blocked. And Schultz gets it knocked away.
Good take by and Schultz.
I could see that elbow from up here.
Yeah.
Walder picks up that foul as well.
Minute 11 to go in the half. Panthers down five. Almost traveled there twice by Schultz.
Pretty close. Well, just a tad short. For Miller had that shot.
Oh.
Nah, and then he just knocks it away.
Well,
a little helter-skelter right now.
Yeah, but, you know, those are hustle plays.
That's right.
Coach, you can't get mad at. You know, some people say that non-conference games don't matter, but it matters to both these teams. Man, they are playing as hard as they can. They're leaving it out there tonight. 44 seconds to go in the half.
Panthers play at have Kewaskum coming in Friday night. And the girls go to Kewaskum on Thursday. Got caught in a defense third. Heck, gets that bucket. Makes it seven with 22 seconds left. They'll stay in that zone.
Well, Panthers intend to take the last shot. Gets it down to Schmidt. Good take by Jordan Schmidt. They were hoping to get that last second shot, but he was so wide open. You got to shoot it.
Yeah, you take it as quickly as you can to get a layup like that.
10 seconds to go. You can't let him get a running start like that. That causes bad things. Heck. Walden at the top of the key, guarded by Schultz. Up, shots missed.
And no bucket. At the half, 36-31. We'll be back with second half action shortly.
Jillian Straub, parents are Greg and Melissa Straub.
Welcome back to second half action. Gary Kaiser on the camera, Josh Oppenheimer, and Mark Melcher bringing you the second half. Well, good ball game so far. Panthers down 5 as we go into the second half. It's a hard fought game. I thought it was well played. A couple of errant passes here and there, but you know, when you're hustling, that's going to happen.
Yeah, I mean, you're exactly right. But that's what both teams want. They want to force you into turnovers, and both teams have had turnovers. I think you'll see in the first 3 minutes, they always say as a coach, that you'll see what kind of adjustments each team made coming out of the halftimes to help them win tonight's game.
The Panthers come back with their starting lineup. And off the side of the rim by Jaquit. And I'm not sure where that foul was, but
I think we got Andrew Miller.
Miller.
Panthers are pretty balanced scoring in the first half. No one in double figures, but they're all up there between 5 and 9.
And nobody really in any foul trouble. Jaquit made enough of that.
Waldner with the shot, missed. Schultz gets the rebound, pulls it up.
He posted him, Schultz, up.
That's a tough move for a freshman to make. You know, if that's, maybe that's their plan, to see if they can post him up down low. And
that could be if you play that zone, or I mean that man-to-man like that.
Oh, I was going to say, I think that's a charge.
And now I get a player control foul again.
I think that's a good call. I don't.
That foul goes, the second one on Easton Deschain. First guy with two fouls in the ball game.
Just in that simple, like 2-3, half, you know, three-quarter trap. Just forcing Plymouth to slow down a little bit.
We've been talking about the shot clock. And Schultz with two quick buckets. The WIA has been talking about a shot clock, 35-second shot clock. And a couple of Division I and Division II like it. The rest of them say no.
You know, it'd be hard to administer it because you're going to have a third person run the clock. Budgets at schools are already tight.
And Jaquit with a block.
And I really don't know, other than maybe one or two teams, an average possession, you know, right now is maybe about 15, 16 seconds. Yeah. I'd like to see them do other things before we get a shot clock. Panthers down one, start the half. Norgaard, deep three, tries to bank it in.
I don't think he chose it, but he did.
Right?
I think he did.
Schmidt with a three from the corner, puts it in.
Schmidt real quick. Panthers go up by 2, 38-36.
Tietz's Piggly Wiggly, with stores located in Plymouth, Howard's, and Sheboygan, is your one-stop shop for all your party needs. Their deli department has a variety of subs, party trays, homemade signature salads, and don't forget the fresh baked hard rolls. Remember to shop the pig and save. Go Panthers. Visit Tietz Piggly Wiggly, 1411 Eastern Avenue. PJ Campbell, the depot, is a casual dining experience, an historic train depot converted into a restaurant. Join their family and enjoy comfort food, which includes steaks, ribs, sandwiches, and German favorites, offering something for everyone. Don't forget the big pretzel and baked French onion soup. Visit PJ Campbell at 114 Depot Road here in Plymouth. Well, that was a quick 30-second butt-chewing by the West De Pere coach. Trying to get his kids to refocus a little bit.
Nice ball movement. And Walter with that bucket. Good pass to Schmidt.
Good pass. Jack Jaquit with a great pass.
Another assist.
Panthers have had a lot of success tonight when they get the ball down in the short corner. And other players are diving through the lane.
Tipped around.
Ulmer with a drive, kick out to Langdon. Pulls up.
That was just a wild shot. I think talking about shot clock. I think he was thinking the shot clock was going off.
Right. Good take by Sass. Just didn't fall. Those are the takes we'll take all night.
It's a tough shot by Walder.
I think you're going to see a tough matchup here tonight between Walder and Caden Schultz. Good kick out. Sass for three.
You can see he took his time on that shot.
Panthers
shot. Up 43-40. Good start of the second half for the Panthers. A little give and go on the inside.
Who did he get the foul on there? I thought he jumped away.
Jake Watt's going to pick up the foul. This is his first.
Meyer Motors in Plymouth offers certified service, sales, parts, and emissions testing. They also purchase vehicles privately for cash. They have a wide variety of new and pre-owned cars, trucks, SUVs. Meyer Motors has been doing business right here in Plymouth since 1926. They pride themselves on customer service with a touch of hometown comfort. Visit them online at www.gomeyermotors.com. 107 Plaza Lane here in Plymouth.
Schultz with a nice drive.
Tough take by Schultz.
He's taken over in the second half. And that quickly, they come with it back with a three. Heck. With that bucket.
Jordan Schmidt. Good take.
Tries tipped around by Shutter. Comes down to the pier. Oh,
good
rebound
by Shutter. I thought we'd have a
Miller with
take by Andrew Miller. Puts the Panthers up one, 47-46 with 13-12 to go.
Whoops.
Heck with a nice move on the baseline.
Little stop and goal.
He's leading all scorers tonight with 15 points. Yeah, 17 points, excuse me.
Quick timeout by Coach Schultz.
Waldo State Bank, local, independent, like you. Waldo State Bank serving the community since 1913, which is ironically the same year Mike Briggs has graduated high school. Visit the depot, Waldo State Bank, at 119 North Depot Street here in Waldo, and they are a member of the FDIC. American Senior Benefits. If you're retiring and eligible for Medicare, turning 65, or just curious to find out if your plan is the right one for you, American Senior Benefits is there to help. Ryan Riley and Kristen Heidemann are experienced in providing personalized services to explain and guide you through their Medicare process and provide you through a free needs analysis with options available at the low cost of the best health care coverage. Visit American Senior Benefits at 1215 Eastern Avenue. Ryan Riley and Kristen Heidemann.
Ames into the ball game, Blod into the ball game.
Well,
Miller almost loses it. Troika as well. DePierre stays in that man.
Good cut by
Troika off their front of the rim, tipped around, gets his own rebound. And we're getting a jump ball.
Alex Ames with a nice basket cut. Kicks it out. We didn't get the basket, but that's good ball movement by the Panthers.
Jake Wood coming back in the ball game.
Shutter with the nice couple minutes in there for the Panthers. We almost got to travel there. Alex Ames, one thing he does well is he will pester you bringing the ball up. He's going to work his tail off. Get on the floor.
Now he grabbed the ball, and I think the ball was on the sideline, so it stays with De Pere.
Refs making sure the floor is not slick right there. Make sure no one gets hurt. Good reffing crew here tonight out of West Bend area. These guys do a nice job every time we see them. There you go.
Up the side of the rim.
Good defensive possession.
Just taken away. And he gets fouled after the shot. Borowitz gets the bucket.
Number one, Bryce Borowitz with the steal and put back.
It was kind of a frustration foul, I think.
Yeah, I think so. I think Coach Schultz is looking to get a jump ball out of that. Panthers down four with 11:50 to go in the game. Phantoms get another steal.
I think we've got a...
Ethan Heck.
We got a timeout coming here pretty soon, Coach Schultz.
He's got 19 points right now for the Phantoms.
They go back into the zone.
Yeah, that's...
Jake went on top looking.
Yeah. Good thing is we're not panicking, right? We're just working the ball around.
And almost taking losing that.
Try to take what the defense is giving you. Good attack by Andrew Miller. Marco Troca. There you go.
Cuts it to four. It quickly comes down. Oh, yeah. Pops up a three. Bounces around and out. Tipped around. Tipped out.
Blod with a good play right there. Got the rebound. Had to fight off a couple of defenders.
No, Jake would.
He was. I saw it right from here. I had a good angle. Just barely touched it. Good move by. Good take by Jack.
And Mass. Line change for the Panthers. Schmidt comes back into the ball game. Along with Sass. Miller, Jaquit, and Schultz besides for the Panthers on the floor. Panthers still down four. Need a good defensive stop at this point. And just that quickly, shuttered his chain.
The take by Jack, missed it.
Tipped Sauce around.
With the putback, missed it again. Phantoms coming down. I think if you get a bucket, you might see a timeout by Coach Schultz. No, no bucket.
And you're going to get a foul. Kraft picks up his second foul.
There you go. Good ball movement by the Panthers. Good shot by Andrew Miller.
Just.
Panthers down three with 9:15 to go in the game.
Miller, or the Panthers got that offensive set going before they could really set up in their zone. And that hit the support, so it'll be Panther ball. Just 9 minutes left, halfway through the second half.
It's been entertaining. been two really good teams, even though their records aren't don't reflect that. They're good teams.
Schmidt looking. De Pere went back into their man. Schmidt for
the shot by Jordan Schmidt. It's short.
And it bounced on the line.
Out of bounds. That's touched by the Phantoms.
Good move by Schultz.
For three.
In and out.
Rims in and out. Good take by Andrew Baumgart. Just like everyone knows, his sleeves are still intact from his arms being so big. He hasn't ripped his shirt and shirt off.
That tipped out of bounds by De Pere.
He's a junior? Boy, he must be a stud on the football field.
Yes, he is a junior. Jake Wood kicks it out. Miller. Miller's looking.
Good take by Andrew Miller.
And what did I get from behind, yeah, I believe.
Van Horn Automotive. Van Horn opened its first dealership here in Plymouth in 1966. As a neighbor for over 50 years, they've now grown to 14 locations statewide and Iowa, with over 3,000 new and used vehicles to choose from at vanhornauto.com. It's as easy as click of the button to find that perfect vehicle. Find your car at Van Horn and we'll be happy to deliver it. See what thousands of satisfied customers have experienced. Van Horn, family born, family owned. Visit Van Horn Automotive.
Well, Miller missed both of those free throws. Had that chance to cut it. And Baumgartner drives the baseline, puts it down. Panthers down seven all of a sudden.
Good take by Jake Watt. Good Jake block. Thought we had a good block there. I didn't see if they should. All right.
De Pere's looking for that travel. As long as he doesn't make a move to get up.
Right.
And he just goes down. It's at not a travel.
At Bait First, we believe in building relationships with creating a better banking experience for our customers. We know our customers by name and make decisions locally, not out of state. We are advocates of customers we serve, and our team bankers enjoy helping people achieve their goals by providing personalized, customized service and value-driven financial solutions. Stop by or visit Bank First at 2700 Eastern Avenue. Plymouth Glass is a family-run business, and we are honored to serve the people of our community. At Plymouth Glass, they offer a wide variety of services, including standard and custom shower enclosures. Visit Plymouth Glass, 402 East Main Street here in Plymouth.
Schultz gets one of two on the free throws. And right into the scorer's booth. They even get into play.
Yeah, this is great.
Ziggy's a little
everyone's
slow on that.
Everyone's excited, and everyone's getting hot. Panthers down six with 7 minutes to go in the game. Highly heated, contested game. Both teams leaving it on the floor. This is wonderful to watch.
Quick movement by the Panthers.
Way to move the ball.
And Sass.
Good ball movement by the Panthers. Get a wide open three. Here at Plymouth 14, we're very fortunate to have all our backers to help sponsor for us to do this, right, Mark?
You bet.
Without them, you and I don't get to sit here and enjoy an evening of good basketball. So once again, we'd like to thank all our sponsors, Miller & Belt, Pata Club, Plymouth Furniture, 2020 Visions, Teets' Piggly Wiggly, PJ Campbell at the Depot, Meyer Motors, the Waldo State Bank, American Senior Benefits, Van Horn Automotive Group, Bank First, Plymouth Glass, Meyer Motors. Just so fortunate to have so many good businesses to help support the kids.
And it makes it good to listen, talking to people that they can stream this from just about any place as long as they've got a internet service.
Yeah.
It's on YouTube. Through the school. Yeah. So,
I'm sure some people are watching on YouTube right now or they're watching TV 14. We're very fortunate. They're probably seeing a good game. They don't have to leave their home. You get to watch, free.
And certainly, if you're close by, stop at one of those sponsors and say thank you for sponsoring Plymouth High School Athletics.
Absolutely.
De Pere inbounds, heck with the ball.
See what kind of adjustments we're making.
Tipped around.
I think we got a foul here on Jordan Schmidt, but as Coach Schill's probably not happy that four white shirts are standing around
and nobody blocked
orange shirts. Yeah. The one guy from West De Pere gets the
Schmidt
rebound.
Schmidt picks up his second foul. Easton Duchesne on the line for two shots. He gets the first one. Shooter comes in for Jaquit. And Easton gets both of those.
Yeah.
And with quick when we come back from shots.
If they're going to let Plymouth pass the ball to sidelines, Sauce has been hot. He's going to keep shooting it all night.
I'd put that X on the floor right over there.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's about three he's hit from over in that spot.
Plymouth's got four guys in double figures right now, which is great. Panthers down two with 6:10 to go in the game. Boy.
And quickly re-answered.
Ethan Heck is a stud. That kid can play.
Takes it back to a 5-point game. Just under 6 minutes left the game.
Heck with 22 points, and he can do it from inside and outside. He's not just limited, just shooting threes all night.
Schultz on top. I think they're reset.
My guess is they're going to try to get Schultz posted up down low. Well.
Shutter looking.
I think that's what they're trying to do. Get Schultz to be a little more aggressive. Good cut by Jordan Schmidt. Good take. And one. Basket's good. Circus shot. Wow. Schmidt trying to get the old-fashioned three-point play, and he does. Puts the Panthers within two. Coach Schultz getting them a little breather, working so hard. Andrew Baumgartner.
Nice little spin move by Baumgartner. Gets that tube. Gives him nine.
I would have shot that.
Miller with a three.
Good ball movement. Andrew Miller.
Found him.
Three from the corner. Panthers have really been moving the ball from top side top all night. Doing a nice job.
Norgard, I think, is going to pick up that foul. That's their sixth, so next will be in the bonus. Again, some substitutions for the Panthers. Schultz coming out. Miller coming out. Ames into the ball game. Along with Troika.
Yeah, Panthers taking what the defense is giving them, not trying to force everything. Moving on with the ball.
Jaquette gets two.
Jaquette. Yep.
And it goes off Jaquette.
Take him.
And they changed the call. Referee underneath had it going down. Jaquette hitting it. Tom Blott comes in.
Panthers inbound in it. Marco with the turnout, missed it. Schmidt with the rebound. Blott kicks it out. Jack with the three from the corner, just rims it in and out.
Good
look. Oh boy. I don't know if anyone would want to take a charge from him. Looks like I'm going to kill someone.
Side rim, Jaquette tips it around to Schmidt. Schmidt comes down with the board.
Heck with the miss. Panthers with the rebound. Jack.
Good idea.
Panthers with the turnover. Going to get... a little hockey substitution going on.
Miller comes back in. Schultz comes back in. Then Soss comes back in.
We're about 3:29 to go in the game, Mark. I think Coach Schultz is going to, with his timeouts, he could probably ride this group of five the rest of the way if he has to. No one's in foul trouble.
No, it's amazing that... right now, we've got 10 fouls between both teams in the second half. Panthers with four.
Schmidt's the only one out there, I believe, with two fouls.
Knocked away by Schmidt, but he gets it back.
Almost gets a steal. Heck with a nice scoop shot just out of rims out. Panthers get the rebound. I think, once again, we're going to try to get Schultz in a post.
Miller on top looking.
There you go. Hold your ground there, young man. Touch it. Touch it. Oh, don't give it up.
Tough. Tough pass.
You got to fly after that ball, even though it's a turnover. You can't let him have that. It's an easy basket for him. Puts him back up by three. 2:20 to go in the game.
Very good. Palmgard picks up that foul. Miller's got another chance. Hit a couple of free throws. And hits the first one.
Doesn't hit the rim. Good shot by Andrew Miller. Up for a second one.
So he finally makes a couple. Cuts that to a one-point advantage for De Pere.
2 minutes to go in the game. Panthers down one, 68-67. Link. Norgaard missed the three. Schultz gets the rebound.
Miller takes his long three.
For three.
And bounces around
good luck.
And out.
Just, out.
Good luck, good shot.
Panthers are going to have to foul at some point here.
Well, they're only down one. I mean, you can let it go for a little bit.
Right, but they only have 14 fouls. You got to get at least two fouls. Because he's... what's going to happen now? West Spears is going to try to run the clock out, and they're going to go to their stall offense. Coach Schultz is smart enough. He's going to tell his guys, we've got to take at least two fouls right away. If we don't get a trap or a steal.
And the crowd goes silent. I don't know.
Yeah, where's the...
what exciting basketball.
Yeah, it's been
a
great
game. Prior to this, the JV... 68-61 winners. They came back from being down, 4 or 5 at halftime and played a good second half.
This is a great non-conference matchup, I believe, for both teams. And I'm not sure, you know, going forward, if they want to continue it. I hope they do. Sometimes teams that have to travel over an hour don't want to do it. But yeah. I think, you know, they're playing 24 games. You got to find teams to play. I think this is going to turn out to be a good non-conference matchup.
And as I said, the crowd's starting to stand, the student section on Plymouth side.
Yeah, they're pretty quiet over there. I mean, well, they're all dressed up nice in their flannels, but they haven't been talking much.
It was a tough day in class, you know, after a week and a half off.
Right. Well,
all right.
Here we go, minute 37 to go. Phantoms are just going to run their motion offense and do some basket cuts. I don't think that they're okay if they don't shoot. Oh, boy, I can't believe that's not a foul. I think Andrew Miller's hurt.
Somebody.
Heck with the basket. I think he's he get run over.
Go up three with just over a minute left.
Plenty of time. No time to panic. We don't have to shoot threes. We just need a basket. Seconds. Don't be surprised if Panthers get a basket. He might take a timeout. Here we go.
Putting it on the perimeter. Now as Chilch is getting it.
Oh.
And it ends up in a jump ball.
Seconds to go. Both teams have three timeouts. They got three fouls to
get. I'm kind of surprised we didn't take a timeout.
I know Coach Schultz less believes in just letting them play. But I think if they can get a basket, a two-point basket, he might take a timeout.
Nope.
West De Pere is going to take a timeout.
They'll take a timeout. I was kind of surprised we didn't foul on that other end of the floor, like you said. Ended up with a 3-point lead for De Pere under those circumstances. And I'm not sure, with 29 seconds left, you're right. If you get a two, hoping for a foul, make it a 3-point.
I know one thing for sure, Mark. As always, I enjoy working with you.
Doesn't happen very often how we get together.
I'm out pounding the pavement, reffing, so I don't get too many of these games anymore. But this has definitely been a good one to do.
Yeah, it sure is. It sure is.
Two very equal teams playing tonight.
29.7 left in the ball game. Panthers inbounding under their own basket. Schultz thought he was going to take the three, and it goes down to 24.
I don't know if they're going to try to foul him. They're going to put it at the line.
That's a good foul. That put on the line for two.
Yeah, they don't want to give up a three.
Now you just have to put these two down or put one down and hope for a long rebound. And
Schmidt
on the line.
People don't realize 19 seconds is a long time in basketball.
And Schmidt's first one. Take one, loses it to Schmidt.
Basket. Yep, Coach Schultz takes a timeout. 10 seconds to go, down one.
Miller gets that. I don't know. He's a little tough getting up on that.
We're taking a full timeout. Panthers putting Marco choking in for Andrew Miller for defensive purposes.
Yeah, part of that, and I think he hit his head on the wall over here on the padding.
But
he had
two plays,
right? Yeah.
He got ran over down below. Yeah. I think took an elbow to his rib cage, and then he got right in his head here. I tell you what, though, he's a tough kid, and he's played hard tonight. So 10 seconds to go. Panthers only have 14 fouls, so they're going to have to foul right away if they don't get a steal. You know, the first option is to get a steal.
Right, right.
Second is to foul immediately. You can't wait. Panther or the Phantoms don't even have to bring it across half court. So this will be interesting. This is fun basketball. And we're only in January 3rd.
Yeah, Happy New Year.
Yeah.
It's a good way to start the new year. If we have a rest of the year this way, it'll be interesting to see us going down to the end of the March.
Yeah, Panthers again at home Friday night against Kewaskum.
Right.
Should be a very good matchup. West Sapir looking to inbound the ball.
And a quick foul. Yeah. By Troika. Doesn't mean much. Other than slows the clock down a bit. It's his second, in case you're interested. Jaquette on the ball, kicks the ball.
Just about two seconds
go off. Saz picks up the foul. And Schmidt picks up the foul there.
All right, so
not sure I wanted
to
put him on the line.
Yeah, that's the one guy you don't want to put on the line, but the worst they can do, they can only be down three.
Miller comes back into the ball game for Troika.
Yeah, and course, timeout coach. By Coach Schultz. Down to one timeout. I think he's going to drop two plays.
I don't know if it's that and try to ice him. I don't know.
Wow, they're trying to ice him, but they're trying to also set up two plays, right?
Right.
If they only need a two, they'll do, you know, play A. If they need a three, they're going to run play B.
I've got Heck with 26.
Hey, so does the board, so man. You guys board. Are in lockstep.
I'm not going to take a promotion to go downstairs.
I wouldn't either.
That's pretty well taken. I got some experienced people down there. All right, back into the action, 6.8. Putting Heck on the line for 1-1.
Oh. Our student section's loud and boisterous tonight. Oh, there they are.
Heck hits the first one, as you can see. Makes it a two-point game.
Well, Heck with the first one made. Here's the second one. Nothing but net. They're good. Coach Schultz using his final timeout. Down three. Drawing up a
down
play.
Need to get the ball down quickly and put it up. Now you need the three. Unless you really get a two and think you get fouled, I don't know. It looks like you almost have to put up a three.
Well, I think that's what West De Pere is going to do. They're going to foul right away.
I would.
Put them at the line.
I can remember some of these officials when my kids were playing, so they've been around a long time as well. The two guys down on the other far end.
Oh, yeah.
They looked a lot younger at that time.
Yeah, they've been around for a while. We do have some state basketball experience here. You know, some of these guys have been down in Madison or Green Bay.
And they're looking for more and more officials all the time.
They're always struggling.
So back in the action with 6.8 left, Panthers going to inbound. De Pere is going to go like a man-to-man press, I would think, just to make sure.
Jake
with a three.
No. Oh, short from the corner.
Short
what
off
a good look
the rim.
Panthers got on that shot.
Good work by the Panthers to get the ball down, get a shot off, but just a little bit short. Panthers come up on a short end in 72-68 ball game tonight, or 69, pardon me, for Gary Kaiser. Josh Oppenheimer, this is Mark Melcher saying, thanks for watching Plymouth High School basketball. Have a good evening.
Game, wasn't it? It was fun to watch.